So traveling with precious metals is an interesting topic. We have two things to consider. One is, what are you bringing with you? And the other is, where are you going? If you're traveling within the United States from state to state, there are no restrictions on what you can bring with you. Of course, you're not going to want to be putting 300 pounds above your head in the overhead, and you're not going to want to check your metal under the airplane. Quite to the contrary, you're going to want to keep it close by, whether it be under your seat or in the overhead, and nimble enough so that you're able to lift it above your head if need be. So let's just simply say you're not going to be taking $10 million worth of gold with you on an airplane. But if you are traveling intrastate, here's how I would do it. First of all, I would keep the gold or silver that I'm bringing with me in a separate box in my carry-on bag. When I get to security, where they're x-raying your carry-on bag, I pull that box out of my bag and I put it on the tray where you would normally put your shoes. And as it's going through the x-ray machine, I do my darndest to make eye contact with the person who is looking at the x-ray machine, and I'll mouth the word coins, my coin collection. 9 times out of 10, that's good enough. On the rare event that they want to see what it is that I'm bringing, because remember, these are non-ferrous metals, it will look like a big black blob on their x-ray machine. If they tweak the clarity, they can see sometimes the delineation between the coins, and they can see the shape, and they're like, okay, you're good to go. We've seen that before, obviously. But on the rare occasion where they do want to see it, it's often prudent to ask for a private screening, where they'll bring you into a room, typically reserved for criminals, just teasing. They'll bring you into a room where they'll privately take a look at what you have with you. And again, there are no restrictions, no declarations, nothing. When you're traveling from state to state, you can bring with you whatever you'd like without declaration, period, no matter what you have. It's when you're leaving the country that it matters. First thing is that you'd want to know where you're heading to. Now, if you're heading to Canada or to most of Europe or to Australia or New Zealand, I would argue that bringing metal with you, if you're forthright and declare it, is completely fine. You wouldn't want to take this, I would argue, to Asia, to South or Central America, to Mexico, where the customs may be slightly different. And if you are going to bring metal with you there, you better darn well know the customs of the place that you are going to, of the destination that you are going to. But as it pertains to traveling outside the country, when you leave the airport that you are traveling in, typically you don't have any declarations. It's when you are going to wherever you are going to where you make said declaration. Now, I will tell you that going into Canada or coming back to the United States, it's the legal tender face value amount of the item that you are carrying with you that matters. So if I'm bringing with me 100 gold maple leaves, which are $50 face value coins, into Canada, I'm not declaring it. Now, the value of that is $200,000 plus, but the face value puts that at $5,000 face value, legal tender, Canadian legal tender, which puts it underneath the limit of declaration. Now, if you're entering Canada or the US with Krugerrands, which have no face value, or gold bars, which have no face value, it's the nominal amount of the gold that you're carrying with you. You have over $10,000, you don't declare it, you're in trouble. So the point is simply this: know what you're traveling with, know where you're going, know what the laws are. When you're in the United States, there are no declarations. And when you're traveling to a destination out of the United States, if it is one of the places that we mentioned, Europe or Canada or the US, it's the face value that matters and the conversion rate of the currency that we're moving into. Always be forthright. Always keep it in a separate bag or in a separate box inside your carry-on. Always act as though you're not trying to hide something. And in doing such, you won't have any problems.